Chalice of Repose Project is a wonderful team of musician clinicians, of others who are also committed to this contemplative way of caring for the dying. When someone has a terminal diagnosis, a stage can be reached when all interventional procedures cease bearing fruit. There's a place where someone doesn't benefit from having one more bone marrow transplant or one more operation. But in fact, it's really clear every life-saving measure possible has been taken. Now it's time to say, this person is really dying. It's important to the doctors, they know that sometimes when there's really nothing more in interventional medicine that they can do, they can also turn to their patients and say, we have something we can do for you. Would you like that we bring in one of the Chalice of Repose workers? Let's call in a music thanatologist. Take the vital signs, and then we begin to make our decisions. We must attenuate the deliveries that we do to fit the needs of each individual person. There is a direct relationship between the melodic content of the music and the neurology of the person. There's a direct relationship between the harmonic content of the music and the respiratory and the circulatory systems. And there's a direct relationship between any use of rhythm and metabolism. So if we were playing for five different people tonight with the same or similar diagnoses, they would each be receiving radically different kinds of musics and deliveries because all the physiological parameters that they each have are different. Try to synchronize our playing with the breathing of the person, with the breathing pattern of the patient. This is about tempo. We zero in, we begin in silence, and then listen very, very carefully and watch. Listen and watch. Listen for your breathing pattern and watch the rise and fall of your chest ever so subtly. And then we begin to play and phrase with you. So just to make it clear, I mean, whether you go, you know, that's one thing, and that's galloping along, which is very, very different from... We synchronize first. We begin the phrase with your inhalation. Whenever possible, we cadence the phrase with your exhalation. And synchronize with the patient's breath in the first 20 minutes or so. And then quietly begin to slow down. This work with the dying had to be called the Chalice of Repose. Any chalice has to be hollowed out on the inside. But it's by being hollowed on the inside that it can both give and receive. Repose is the ancient word for a holy rest, deep holy rest. And in an earlier time, death was considered a kind of deep and holy sleep. So Chalice of Repose. And whenever I look at flowers, especially lilies, I see the inverted chalice. To me, I think that's how we have to be. We have to be kind of like still flames. We have to be fragrant. We have to be very, very still and inwardly calm in order to work in the middle of chaos, in the middle of adversity. And That takes a certain emptiness, a certain strength, a certain commitment to both give and receive, to take care of ourselves and to respond to the world. I really lost a lot of the people that I love already in my life. I had to go through that loss completely and deeply. I had to grieve. It's like huge wounds. And until I had the courage to go all the way through those wounds, I wouldn't bring any light to the world. By working with the dying this way and in this new way, and by learning how to die to something little every single day, we enter more fully into life, much more fully into life. It helps teach me on an hourly basis to appreciate what I have, to know that none of us knows how long we're going to have. We have to let the people that we know we love, we must tell them we love them. We never know if we'll have tomorrow. And so it's invited me to engage myself much, much more deeply in life, in the world, with the whole body, with the heart, with the mind, with my intention, with work, with play. I love the four seasons. And this time of the year now, fall, we see all the leaves dying and turning gold and red and falling to the ground. I need that. I need that, and I need the winter as much as I need the spring and the summer. But I understand that if I have the courage to live all the cycles more deeply and more fully, I have more to give the living.